and gentlemen, welcome back to Albion College. Some of you, it's been a year, I recognize. It's really nice to be able to perform here in front of a live audience. And we're really excited to have all of you here to share the experience. My name is Sam McIlhagga. I'm the director of bands for a couple more weeks before I ride off into the sunset. Retirement from Albion College, hopefully quietly. Anyway, we're going to perform a number of different things for you this evening. They're new pieces because composers in the time of COVID have been asked to create pieces of music that can work with all sorts of different combinations of instruments. So that if you have students that have to quarantine or have to perform remotely or something like that, we can still make music and not have to worry about the concert band setup that we normally have. So we're really excited to play these pieces for you. They're really fun. We're also going to feature a couple of our student musicians that had some recitals this year, and we'll intersperse that with some other things as well. Again, I just want to thank you all for being here, and we really appreciate having an opportunity to share some music with you tonight.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. So, like I said, we're featuring a few student musicians as well. The first musician that we have up here is a junior saxophone performance major. And she just had her junior recital a couple weeks ago. And I asked her if she would perform part of her recital on the concert, just as a way to give us a break and to fill out the concert and to give her another chance to share the music with some other people that might not have heard it the first time. So let me introduce to you all, please, Allie Garland.
Thank you. also did a recital earlier this semester, so
thank you.
So traditionally, our final concert of the season always ends with an acknowledgement of the folks that have been around for 4 years playing these groups, and this year is no different. I feel kind of badly because last year, you know, we had to kind of bug out here really quickly, and we didn't have an opportunity to do this for all of the seniors from last year. I see one of them in the back there. He's kind of looking around, but everybody's saying congratulations to John Todd Wallace back there. You can help me out if I don't see another senior from last year that's out here. Tell me. I think that's it. Okay. And I'll congratulate all of those of you that are watching. If you're a senior from last year, congratulations. Way to go. I hope we'll see some of you guys at the commencement. This year they're doing two commencements on the same day, one for the class of 2021, and then later in the afternoon they're doing a commencement for the class of 2020 as well. So they'll get their opportunity to walk still, which is kind of a nice thing. But I'd like to take just a few moments here and just recognize the seniors of the band here. You can see their little bios in the program. I would like to point out just a couple of things, which I think are unique about Albion College and about small liberal arts colleges in general. Most of our students that participate in music here on campus are not music majors. The majority of them just participate because they love music, they want to continue making music. And this group is no exception. We've got international studies galore from all of the people up here, and biology majors, and we've got some computer science folks, and just all sorts of different things. It's really cool to see them, you know, come out of these crazy, like, left brain type experiences all day long, and then spend some time in their right brain for a while, and it's really a joy to be able to work with them. I'm going to miss them very dearly. I'm not going to get choked up. So just if you would, guys, when I announce your name, if you would just come up and accept the applause, and we'll just do this alphabetically. So the first person on our list is Jesse Butchley. Section and one of our band librarians, along with Jesse, is Annette Vargo. And pulling double duty in both band and choir for 4 years? Did you do all 4 years? Impressive is Tori Weese. Person who has been sort of the live stream guru here for the music department these last month or so. We're really grateful and sorry to see him go in the trombone section. Evan, he's able to. To reacquaint my ears with something. Hold on a second. Okay, so the first award, first couple of awards that we have are the Faculty Accommodation Awards. These awards go out to students, usually in their senior year when they've spent 4 years with us, and maybe they've been sort of unsung heroes, right? They're the people that set up the chairs, they're the people that do the library work for us, they're the people that are generally always there early and always there after everybody else goes home, and it's no exception this year, and these people will be sorely missed. So Jessica Butchley. Come on up. You're probably wondering why she flipped me off right there. That's Jessie's award for cutting off part of her finger with the big paper slicer. Yes. Another one that's again an unsung hero in both band and in choir. She was choir manager for how many years? 4 years, all 4 years. And she's done an incredible job for us here as well. We're really happy that she's We're happy that she's going on to greater things. How's that? Tori Wiese. And last but certainly not least, Faculty Accommodation Award. Another band librarian, person that just puts in a number of hours just keeping things organized and making sure that we've all got our music when we need it. Annette Parker. Some of the awards are not necessarily meant for band or choir, they're just music department awards. This one in particular is called the Donald White Music Theory Award. It goes to whoever has the best overall grade in the first year music theory class. This year that award goes to Luke Rivard. This is awarded to a sophomore or a junior music student who is just exceptional in their musical skills. This year, this award goes to Samantha Etoll. There are two last band-specific awards. The first one is the one that I told you about. It's called the Earl Slocum Award. It goes to the student who's made the most outstanding contribution to the Albion College bands this year. It's an award that's voted on by the students. So it's really an acknowledgement by your peers of all of the things that you've done to make the bands a better place. And this year, the award goes to Charlotte. Certainly not least, is the Michael Noonan Band Scholarship. This award goes to a member of the College Marching Band who demonstrates and exemplifies enthusiasm for Albion College, which manifests itself in spirited leadership of the band. This award, practically unanimous, goes to Lewis Eastmead. It's been 17 years. I came here in 2003. It's your movement behind me. It's like a cabin.
Never
mind
the uniform.
Just ignore the people. Okay. 2003 is when I came here. My wife and then daughter, who was not quite 2 years old, Emma, was here, and this place has been a home to not just me, but to my whole family for the last 17 years. And in that time, we had a second daughter who happened to be born right after a home football game. My wife told the band if they did a good enough performance at halftime, it might put her into labor. And sure enough, it did. I don't think I've ever run so fast to get the car in my life. The number of things that we've done here in the past 17 years has been truly incredible. This last year has been just a whirlwind of ups and downs and difficulties, and to be able to come through it all and make music for you all here today, I think is a testament to the students who I've always said are the biggest reason why I love Albion College. The students are what make it special here. Whether they've graduated back in 03, 04, and I know some of you guys are watching right now, or they're graduating this spring, it's just, it's a family. It's always been a family, and I may be leaving this year, but the family remains, and I will always be a part of Albion, Albion will always be a part of me, and it's just been a true pleasure to spend some time with you guys, and thank you so much for being here.
Thank you. We'll be right back.